I listened to some radio when I walked Bear as well.
Now, Joe Burrow, it's amazing how colleges, and I always, when I hear a story like this, I wonder how many people never get the chance. He was a backup quarterback at Ohio State for 3 years. He couldn't get on the field. I think he threw like 30 passes. If he doesn't transfer LSU, he never makes it.
No.
He probably, a long shot as a walk-on somewhere, which they wouldn't even pay that much attention to him. He's going to be the number one pick in the draft. He never would have made it. He threw 60 TD passes this year. He never would have made it. How many people are stuck behind a Dwayne Haskins or a great quarterback that never got the chance and could have been great?
Speaking of Haskins, I just can't help but sit here and think, man, I wish this kid was an option. He's someone to me that you watch and you know right away he's pretty close to ready. Burrow looks ready. He does so many things well, too.
And
he can move, man.
See, football's the one sport that does not really help when you're a late bloomer, right? Because you got to be on the same schedule as everybody else.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, you'll be baseball players. They kind of maybe find it a little bit later on. And through the minor leagues, it takes them a while to get going. And then they can still have a career. But football careers are so short that if you're like a late bloomer, then you don't get drafted. You don't get the chance.
What about Chris Wehnke?
You need somebody to get hurt.
He was like Van Wilder.
Hey, when would we have found out about Brady? You'd ever say, well, eventually we would have, but when?
Yeah. He got stuck behind Drew Henson, and then he split time with Drew Henson, and there was a quarterback before
Bledsoe doesn't get hurt, right? Bledsoe plays the rest of that season. I don't remember what Bledsoe's contract situation was, but maybe it's another couple of years before Brady gets a chance.
Absolutely.
And then maybe it's not with New England, and he goes to a team that's awful and a team that can't mature a quarterback and has a terrible coach, and who knows? You know, so I think in other sports, there's so many games to play that you get an opportunity to kind of show. But in football, there's so few games. How often can a backup quarterback play? He needs an injury to get a chance to play.
And it can't be an isolated incident. There has to be many, many people who are in their 50s, sitting at home, never got the chance because they went to a school where there was an abundance of talent, and they never got the chance to start, and they could have been great. But Joe Burrow rewrote his history. He went to LSU, took a chance. They changed their offense after he was there. Last year, if you look at last year's numbers for Joe Burrow, ordinary. He would have been a walk-on after this year. But they brought in the guy from the New Orleans Saints. They high-powered offense, and the guy had one of the great seasons of all time. Now, Trevor Lawrence, who many consider one of the best quarterbacks in college football history, had never lost before, and he looked like a different guy yesterday.
Yeah.
And LSU is the real deal. They beat seven teams in the top 10. They beat most of those teams by double digits. They were unbelievable. But Trevor Lawrence, that's a pedestrian day. 18 for 37, 234 yards. Didn't throw a TD. And that's not the guy that we're used to seeing. So congratulations to LSU. They have not had an undefeated season, I think, since the late 50s. So it's been about 60 years. Amazing.